Tatiana, I'm very, very pleased to see you again in Brussels at the Parliament. You've been the first and foremost MEP, as from my perspective, in London. Coming from Latvia, what does the whole situation look to you?
The situation has been a mystery for me initially when I received first letter from one Latvian citizen, resident of Netherlands. She was deprived of nine years, and they were sent to social care. And then I have discovered more and more cases, and this situation is not is elaborating in the worse direction, despite all the efforts undertaken by authorities, executive authorities of Latvia, such as Ministry for Judiciary, Ministry for Foreign Affairs, consulates. We managed to enforce them to take part in all proceedings concerning Latvian citizens when being abroad. Also, not only my part, my activities as a member of the European Parliament, but we added some interested persons in Latvian Parliament, members of Latvian Parliament, and they managed even to organize a hearing within the Committee on Human Rights. But still, all our efforts did not stop this situation of withdrawing children in Britain, in particular. And I have data from Latvian Ministry of Foreign Affairs that only for two first months of this year, January and February, 11 children were withdrawn from the families of Latvian citizens in Britain.
11 children in 2 months in the UK alone.
It's a lot.
It's a lot, and it's too many, and nearly every child is too many, it seems. I have observed the trend that foreigners seem to be targeted. Can you confirm that?
Yeah, I think that's... and foreigners mostly from EU, Eastern and Central Europe.
Eastern European
from
countries.
New EU member states,
that they come for jobs and they lose their children.
Yeah.
That's the pattern. What do you think we as petitioners or parents deprived of their children could do?
Yeah, only way is to raise more and more awareness. We have first signs of positive behavior and also a bit reflection of those concerned of their not full, how to say, immunity from being questioned, their behavior. I mean, social workers in Britain, also judges, since, first of all, we managed to involve embassies, so embassies are representing during the court hearings. We managed to have a fact-finding mission to Britain, headed by the proper chair of petitions committee and with the full representation of all political groups. And the agenda of these hearings, of this mission, which took place in November, was very tough, and we spoke to all parts involved, including judges, social workers, people, NGOs who are just standing on the rights of defending the rights of families being deprived of children. Also, we met former and actual members of Parliament. It was also representatives of Interior enforced. You are calling them intelligence service, etc., Scotland Yard in Britain, policemen. And even social workers, were not so one-sided oriented. Some of them doubted on the justification of their too much of their offensiveness when deciding to deprive parents from their children. So we have just today passed by the vote on recommendations from the drawing from this fact-finding commission, and description of activities we undertook during this fact-finding commission is also very exhaustive and very very honest and objective, and recommendations are the ones we spoke a lot about. First of all, the recommendation to inform immediately when the child is withdrawn appropriate embassies who's representing the country whose citizens are these children or parents or both. Also request to define better and to investigate better the situation of the child itself, because there is a misuse of the term habitual residence of the child, even when child can be not all the time living in Britain or visiting parents, but returning back to very often to great parents who are caring them when parents are leaving Latvia for Britain to work for some employment. And despite all this fact, children are regarded to be residents of Britain. Also in Latvian civil code it is told that any person can have more than one place
of residence.
Permanent residence. Yeah. So that concerns the possibility to transport the case to the jurisdiction of the court of the state of citizenship, not the British court. And here, unfortunately, up to now, we did not have any simple example of agreement to give up the case from British jurisdiction to another jurisdiction, and British courts and British judges are thinking, are convinced that they are the best ones all over the world, and it's their capacity to do all the best for the child, which is questioned by many people. And there is interesting case, I don't want to discover the name, but there is a withdrawal of child from mother, and we managed to involve immediately Latvian embassy and Latvian consulate. And last 1 month ago, we were upset of the judgment not to agree to transpose this case to Latvian jurisdiction. Also, there was a proper request from Ministry of Justice, from Foreign Affairs Ministry, consulate was represented. There was a decision that the sister living in Latvia can be can take care of the child as a care person instead of mother, if they think that mother was
not good,
behaving wrongly with respect to the child. All this finalized with refusal to transpose the case. But in 1 month, last Friday, the proper British court was positive, and they took accusation of mother beating the girl. There was wrong evidence, and they decided that the evidence was wrong, and it was not proved. And they changed the decision how often she can meet the daughter. Now she received more often visits. And she was very positively, how to say, she has a lot of hopes that the next trial in 3 months, it will be in June, will finally decide to
return
to her, the daughter, and I received very positive feedback from her family, from the sister living in Latvia. So
there is
maybe
hope.
Something is changing to the best side. I hope so.
I think we need to close. There's too much, that many people coming out of the room now. There's too much. No, is it okay? Continue? Because after having talked to more petitioners today, I thought it might be a good idea to come up with an international petition, especially between Germany, Sweden and the UK. Would that help, you think?
Yeah, why not? You can table the text and then gather signatures in all three states. We are doing one international petition on another issue, on mass statelessness. From both Estonia and Latvia. This is a problem, particular problem of Estonia and Latvia, my state and neighboring Estonia. When reconstructed pre-war citizenship, many of people found themselves stateless. All those who moved to these territories after the Second World War. And we managed to table this petition in previous legislation, separately from Latvia, separately from Estonia, but now we are gathering signatures thanks to the fact that in the new parliament elected in 2014, we have more representations of those being aware of this problem, and we have representatives of different political groups giving a majority now for tabling this petition finally to plenary to have a recommendation and resolution on that subject.
Apropos plenary, do you put a lot of hope on the plenary debate next week?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, it is a progress. Since the Committee of Petitions, by different reasons, did not manage to receive a majority of political groups, it is always needed. That's politics. We need a majority of elected persons to push forward some text, some resolution, some questions, some debate. And unfortunately, Committee of Petitions was reluctant to have a consensus for moving some questions. The very same problem of statelessness was blocked by right-wing parties, also members elected in the very same state as I'm elected from, but representing just opposite to political view and political platform. So in the case of child protection, there are evident differences between right-wingers and left-wing politicians. And some of them think that state must interfere much more, and the parents are not able to
look after
to be involved in the destiny of their children as far as they seem to look for, and it depends on traditions, of course. I think that this approach is neoliberalism, some kind of neoliberalism, which is repeating accusations on the beginning of 20th century against communists, against Bolsheviks, accusing them to abolish the right of the family to work for collectivization of children and then giving them to the state care, etc., etc. And now this neoliberalism repeats these accusations, because these accusations were false accusations. Of course, there were many children without parents after the First World War. It was a disaster, also in Russia, and a lot of children, establishments where children without parents were living together and educated and so on, were created in this time. But it was situation not created artificially, as it seems to be now, when children are simply taken away families, which are, you can doubt. We have heard from one judge in Britain when we have met. He himself was educated in care family, and his approach was that it gave him chance to the good career. He was taken from lower classes strata of the society to the middle strata of so-called middle class, and it gave him more chances for career, for education, etc., etc. And he told that it must be most as a rule to take children from problematic families. Well, while, for example, my point of view, when I'm a person coming from mostly traditional society, being orthodoxal, people in Orthodox, educated in Orthodox belief, I think that even some default in the family, no one is perfect, and maybe some problems occur, but still native biological parents are biological parents. And even children withdrawn from families, we know a number of examples, they are looking for their biological parents, their love their biological mother, despite maybe her deficiencies. You have that's a problem of just of vision of a human being for which purpose he is born, what is tradition for him, what is family for him. And here we find also different political opinions on this matter.
You started by saying raising awareness is the most important. Have you been aware of getting children adopted for the purpose of abuse?
Unfortunately, I cannot, being a mathematician, I cannot make a statement, since there is not yet a proof of this suspicion. It's very difficult to prove.
Well, it so happens that I know a case.
Unfortunately, we have also data, mostly concerning, to my regret, Roma families and Roma children.
In the UK? Or anywhere?
You see, there is one new member state where international adoption is completely prohibited, and this is Romania. And Romania just tackled a number of cases of such kind of usage of children from Roma families for not for adoption, but just for another use, for trafficking, for different completely unhuman purposes. I don't want to mention, but you can suppose what it is,
we
are speaking about.
Yes,
so the decision of the country was to prohibit international adoption totally.
As a safeguard?
Yeah.
Isn't that interesting? Is there anything else you'd like to add to complete this fabulous conversation?
Yeah.
Thank you very, very, very much. It certainly gives me hope to continue as well.
Yeah, I have answered most of your questions.
You certainly have, and I feel confirmed in what I wanted to take forward to go home and to collaborate with.
Thanks for coming to Brussels.
Well, thank you for having us and for hosting us so beautifully. Thank you.